took the attack back to the Aussies a little bit, positive cricket, and still hope tomorrow.
I hope so. Obviously, Ben Stokes has played fantastically well tonight as well, which is great to see a 22-year-old come out and play like that. You know, he's incredible with the ball as well. The way he just kept running in, and certainly in hot conditions as well, was a great sign for the future as well. So fingers crossed he can go on and get 100 tomorrow. And obviously Matty Pryor's there as well, so we know that there's possibility of runs there, but we've just got to go out and keep fighting.
And what was it like being with Ben in that partnership? He didn't seem to take any notice of anything going on around him and just played his natural game.
No, I think that's one of his strengths. You know, he keeps it very simple, doesn't get fazed by a lot. You know, and that's a really good encouraging sign, I think, for him going forward. You know, I think the way he strikes the ball down the ground really cleanly but plays so straight, and the pace he can bowl as well, I think it's a great find for us, and you know, I think he's got a massive future ahead.
I know it's England are up against it, of course, on the final day, but is it a case of perhaps trying to put pressure back on the Aussies and make them start thinking about a few things tomorrow?
Yeah, absolutely. I think certainly the wicket we're on as well, with the cracks and stuff, I think you know, you have to be positive. If you get one that hits the crack and stays low, then you know, fair enough, but I think you have to show positive intent. You can't just try and survive, and we've got to try and put a little bit of pressure on Australia. And you know, that's the, you know, the beauty of Test cricket. You know, you've got to try and put the bowlers under pressure. You can't just sit there and survive. So hopefully there'll be a bit more of that tomorrow.
Well, you look fluent again out there. Is it just frustrating for you that you've not been able to go on as yet to that bigger score?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, scoring hundreds is what wins Test cricket. You know, and 50s. You know, even though they're nice, you know, they don't really get you, you know, get very far in terms of winning games. So obviously it's nice to be playing well, but you know, obviously we want to go on and get some big scores.
Another new ball is around the corner, 10 or 12 overs away. I guess the hope is these guys get through that. And then it's build as big as possible. We saw Auckland earlier in the year. You never know what can happen.
No, you don't. Cricket's a funny game. Obviously, we need a bit of luck go our way. And two guys to play brilliantly well. So, look, I'm pretty sure the guys who are going to walk out in the morning believe that they can do something special. And I hope they can.
And of course, Pryor did it in Auckland. He'll be hoping for more of the same.
Exactly. He's got it in the, you know, in the past. And, he's got a great record in Test cricket as well, so he'll have the belief and the experience to go out and do that.
Just finally then, I'll let you go, Belly. What does it mean that England do take this game deep as far as possible tomorrow for the dressing room? Because obviously it's not been the easiest first few Test matches or even first 4 days.
No, it hasn't. I mean, we haven't played anything near where we need to if we're going to compete with Australia. Look, we want to take this deep, we want to take this as close as we can. If we get a chance of winning it, great. If not, we've got to keep fighting. And that's the place we've got to be. You know, we can't go away from that. We've got two more games to go. We have to keep fighting and trying to improve. You know, we can't walk away from it. We just got to, you know, just take it on the chin and keep moving forward.